Hey, Michael Church, Crawl Space Ninja and Basement Ninja, and today I want to show you a couple of quick tips that you can do in order to keep rainwater and surface water and even a little bit of under the ground water off of your house, whether you got a basement or a crawl space. Stay tuned. Okay, so keep in mind that this project is a pretty easy DIY project, which may require you to rent a backhoe or a ditch witch if you want to get it done real quick, especially if you live in East Tennessee or in a place that has a lot of clay or hard soil. It's not an easy project, but it certainly is one that can be done by the homeowner, unlike maybe a crawl space encapsulation or a basement that might be a little bit more difficult to accomplish by yourself. So what you want to look at here is they had some surface waters that was going into the basement and they wanted to redirect that water. Now, it didn't stop the water from going into the basement. Keep that in mind. A lot of people say that if you redirect water from the outside, it's going to stop the basement water. Well, water takes the path of least resistance. Once the water has started going into the basement, it's really difficult to stop it without either redoing the outside of the basement or an interior waterproofing system. So here are a couple of videos and some images of what I'm talking about. Okay, so this is the ground level view from the front door. As you can see, there is a slope that comes towards the house from a road. And what they did here was they dug a shallow French drain. Remember, we are in East Tennessee and we do have a lot of clay. So they dug a shallow French drain all the way. You can kind of see it, not really in the video, but there's a little bit of a dip right here that goes all the way to this little NDS valve. And the reason why they wanted that is so they could see if there was actually water in there, and there is. Might be hard to see in the camera, but water was pooling up in this area, so they created a way for the surface water to make its way into the French drain faster right there. Now, you can even create these multiple drain openings like that if you like, but they felt this was good enough for this small yard, and then it gets directed all the way around. Now, this is another rise. It actually rises up that way like that. So they were taking on water this way, okay? So they caused that to go down the hill over past the yard. All right, the other thing you want to look at is they took this downspout right here and it was draining right here by the foundation. They did re-slope some of this away so that again it creates the water to get away from and then go down any surface water, but they also took the roof water and tied it over there as well to go down the hill get off of the property past the yard. So this retainer wall was built in order to keep obviously soil and different things like that from coming onto the driveway. This driveway has actually been replaced as well. This is about a three-year-old driveway, but look what they did to improve the flow of the water away from the house. Now, as you can see, the concrete is broken up quite a bit, and even back up underneath there, the concrete is broken up. This is all from when the downspout drained right here. It also helped break up the asphalt of the past driveway. So what they decided to do was to get that water underground. So they put in an under the asphalt system. This asphalt is sitting on a pretty thick bed of rock, gravel, but it's also been diverted all the way past the driveway, which is a pretty good feat, all the way to there where that white pipe is, okay? So just keep that in mind. The other thing I want you to notice was there was another downspout right here that also was breaking up the concrete right here in front of the garage. You can see some of this water damage in front of the garage. All right, so what they did here was they actually diverted the downspout and took it from there and moved it to there. So now they've got this downspout right here, all right, that again is going down into the ground and then being diverted to that pop-up valve sitting right out there. So these are some of the things you may have to redirect, some downspouts and different things like that to get this water off of your house, but it is well worth it. Keep in mind that it's not going to stop water intrusion in many cases if you've got a flood or something like that, but in these instances it certainly does help to break up or to stop the breakup, or to minimize the breakup, I should say, of the concrete. I really appreciate you watching that video, and I hope you liked the video down below. And if you got some ideas for some basement waterproofing videos or things like that, please let us know. My name is Michael Church with Crawl Space Ninja and Basement Ninja. Hope you make it a happy and blessed day, and we'll see you later.